For those with more darkly inclined tastes, you know, the necromancers, the six house cultists, and the various data worshippers out there, you may find today's one of the day to just be something you might be interested in, because today we're taking a look at Dark Castle by Lazz, and if that sounds a bit familiar, that's because we have actually, you know, showcased this mod before a really long time ago. 7 years ago, in fact, we showcased this in 2014 for the 6th episode of Morrowind Modding Showcases, and gosh, that was such a long time ago. We've been doing this for 7 years. I was 24 when we last, you know, showcased this mod, you know, 24, freshly graduated from university, and with a bit of a naive sense of the world, I dare say, but here we are again, you know, showcasing Dark Castle for the second time, because it did receive a major update in 2018, overhauling the exterior to make it more castle-like, and also overhauling the interior a bit. And of course, you know, we do have better recording software these days. You know, back when we started, we had huge issues with, you know, FPS and stuttering and all that, which, you know, isn't really an issue these days. But anyway, the main entry hall here opens up into the throne room, which has a lot of display cases and, you know, places to show off your stuff. And going into the master bedroom, you'll find a positively cozy and atmospheric, you know, main bedroom chamber with, you know, the bed up on a platform here, a small private dining table and a reading nook, and you gotta love the gardens and the ivy here. It's just really fantastic, and of course there's a cozy roaring fireplace here. Not exactly the sort of thing you'd expect to find in a darkly themed castle mod, but you know, we'll get to the dark bits here in just a little while. But first, you know, taking a look at your private bathing chambers, which are just attached to the master bedroom, you'll find a bit of a swimming pool with just some fantastic interior lighting that's just, again, really atmospheric. And, of course, you know, you got these gardens here to, you know, the signs, and this is just a really cozy, lovely, and homey set of chambers here, and, you know, it's probably the coziest part of this castle. You know, it is supposed to be a bit of an evil, darkly themed castle, but most of that stuff is actually kind of hidden a bit, and it does have these really cozy areas, but next up, we're taking a look at the dining room, which you can see here. And it's not a huge dining room, but it has a fairly sizable, you know, set of tables here, and some guest bedrooms off to the side, a bar, and there's a small kitchen off to the off to the side here. Nothing too fancy, just, you know, basically a table, a wine rack, and, you know, a fireplace, and that's it. But, you know, attached to the dining room, you'll find the grand library, which includes just a ton of bookcases that you can store books in, and also a few NPCs that offer, a variety of services like spellmaking, enchanting, transport to Balmora, and, some bartering services and whatnot. You'll also find just two guest bedrooms, you know, just attached to the library here. These are, you know, somewhat cozy, but this is the last of the civilized parts of the castle. The rest is the more darkly bits that are just sort of hidden off to the side, including this sort of torture chamber. There's lots of blood, lots of flayed bodies, and six house, you know, items here. Very darkly themed. There's even a room of just bones and skeletons, and you also got these rivers of blood and whatnot. This might be a great home for, like, a vampire, or, you know, something of that nature. But anyway, that's just That's all there is to see here, so that's from other day. As always, I've been your host, Dark Elf Guy. Thanks for watching, stay safe, stay healthy, happy modding, and I'll see you all next time.